guys, welcome back to my channel. Hope you've all had a wonderful day. Today's video is my reading wrap-up for May. I've actually had a really, really good reading month throughout May, and I had some really great books that I kind of flew through. There were two that I planned on carrying on into June because I didn't get the time to get to them. However, I did actually have an extra day in May, so I managed to finish one of them, so only one will be rolling over into June. But yeah, I had 8 books on my TBR, and I read 7 of those books. I read 8 in total, but I read 7 of those books. So the one I don't have to show you was one of the Famous Five ones. And it was 5 Go Off to Camp by Enid Blyton. I love the Famous Five stories. I think they're really good. I gave it 3 stars. There's not loads I can tell you about it, but it was a good story. It's one of my favourite ones of the series. I only give it 3 stars because although it's a childhood favourite and I love it, it's not one I would rate super highly. It's just like an old faithful that you know that you'll enjoy. So yeah, there is that. Then I think the first book I actually read was Lyra Bird by Cecilia Ahern. And this follows a girl called Laura Button who has the ability to copy sounds perfectly. And she is put onto like a stage show, a little bit like X Factor, I assume, and it's about her being protected from the lights of the city, kind of. It's a protect the innocent from the big bad wide world. That's probably the worst explanation you'll ever hear. It was okay. I gave it 3 stars. I'm not a huge fan of Cecilia Ahern, so it really doesn't bother me that I didn't feel either way about this one. Yeah, an emotional love story with great heart. I'm not sure how I feel about that. It was okay. And I think if you're a slice of life kind of book person, this will be for you. It's just not for me. So yeah, 3 stars and I finished it and I liked it. But yeah, it's what it is. Next up, I actually read 8 Ghosts by the English Heritage. Sorry, all the books are like balanced near my tripod. So yeah, I read 8 Ghosts by the English Heritage. So it's 8 different ghost stories written by 8 different authors. There are a couple in here that I read and honestly, I was just completely confused. I was like, I have absolutely no idea what the point of that story was, and obviously because they're little mini ghost stories, they're only about 10-15 pages, 20 pages each. But there were 2 stories in here that I read and instantly felt very uncomfortable, like felt creeped out and a little bit like it was too real, which is fab because you want to be immersed in that kind of ghost story. And knowing that you've only got 20 pages to do it, to make the reader feel like that, is fabulous. And if the 2 books were standalones, I would probably keep them on my shelf. But because there were only 2 out of the 8 that I really felt have stuck with me, it's probably not something I would read again. I really recommend giving it a read, because I think they were really good, but would I read it again? Probably not. I gave it 3 stars. As I said, if it had been the 2 that I really enjoyed as standalones. I'd have probably given it more. But yeah, based on that, I didn't. What did I read next? I read I read the 2nd book in the Rosemary and Thyme series. This is A No Birds Sing. I gave this 4 stars and it follows Rosemary Boxer and Laura Thyme who are going to sort out a... Oh no, this is the first book. I read them in the wrong order. This is the first book. They go to the same house in the same village, and a friend of Laura's passes away, and a friend of Rosemary's is very sick, and they kind of go to sort out the garden together but discover different things and kind of solve the mystery, which I love. So yeah, I gave it 4 stars. I would definitely read it again. And there were little parts of it that were different to the TV series that I'd seen, which I really enjoyed. So yeah, loved it. Thought it was great. Next up was Last Orders at the Start and Sixpence by Holly Hepburn. I absolutely loved A Year at the Star and Sixpence. It was possibly one of my favourite books of last year. And this one, it was okay. Like, I enjoyed it, and I enjoyed being back in the world of Little Monkham, but I felt a little bit like the author tried to cram 2 or 3 different problems into one book. And although it's quite a chunky book, I felt like the change between each problem was quite swift. And I didn't really like it. I would have preferred one issue to be the ongoing storyline, like it was in the first book. So each sister would have an issue that they would deal with, whereas in this it felt like there was 2 deaths, there was a birth, there was a like dodgy relative, there was like relationship makeups and breakups, and it just felt like way too much to be going on in one book. I don't know if I would ever read this one again. I'm not sure if I would just keep A Year at the Star and Sixpence and count that as the novel finished. I'm not sure. It may have to be like a reread of the two together to see kind of how I feel reading them in succession, and then I think I'd be able to tell you, but yeah, I'm not sure about that one. I gave it 3 stars. Oh no, I gave it 4. That's interesting. Maybe I gave it 4 because, yeah, I think I gave it 4 because I liked the story and I liked being back in the world. I just didn't love, I didn't love it. I know that A Year at the Star and Sixpence was a 5-star though, I can remember that. Right, next up was my buddy read with the lovely Nikki, and it's Charlotte Bronte's Jane Eyre. This is my all-time favourite classic. It actually took me a little while to get through it this time round. I listened to a lot of it via audiobook, and then I read the last 3 chapters in physical form because they're my favourite 3 chapters. And I just remember, like, reading it when I was younger and feeling the same way I felt about it when I was younger and loving Jane and Mr. Rochester and their sarcastic but funny, wholesome relationship. It's a favourite. I love it. So yeah, this one will probably be a 5-star. It's always a 5-star. I love it. So there's that one. I read Evil Thing by Serena Valentino. This one follows Cruella de Vil and her side of things and how she went from being who she was to being the, you know, evil thing that tried to steal the puppies. I gave this book 4 stars. I loved it, but I felt really sad when I finished it. Like, her story was so sad and tragic that I just felt really emotional. Like, I felt like she was a real person that I could, I don't know, I just sympathised with her story so much. I just felt so sad that her life had gone that way. I know it's a book. I know it's a book and she's not real. But it just made perfect sense to me, the way she went, the way she did, if that makes sense. I think if you haven't read it, I really recommend you do. But yeah, it just made me feel so sad. Like, I remember finishing it and just feeling really deflated because it was like I wanted her to have a happy life and it just didn't happen. So, yeah, I reckon this is possibly my favourite villains one so far. Maybe. So, yeah, there's that one. And then the last two I had were Knife by RJ Anderson and Frozen Charlotte by Alex Bell. And when I filmed my TBR video, I said, I've got these two left, I want to carry them into June. But I'd actually still got the last weekend of May, and the weather was gorgeous. So I sat out in the garden and I finished this in a day. It was actually quite a chunky book, of 350 pages. And I devoured it, like could not put it down. I think this is a young adult. I mean, it's not for younger readers, but it's a young adult red eye horror is what they're called, I think. And basically it follows a girl called Sophie who goes to spend the summer with her cousins, and lots of strange things happen. It just says, the girl with a room full of antique dolls, the girl that shouldn't be there, the girl that died. And oh my god, I loved it. Like, would pick it up and read it again right now. It was so good. It might not be everyone's cup of tea. Like, I can imagine people are sitting here going, well, I've read that and I thought, you know, I didn't think it was great. But it really stuck with me. It really creeped me out, which is what I love in like a horror kind of book. But it wasn't too gory or too horrible that I felt like, ooh, I really didn't enjoy reading that. So yes, loved it. They do a set of these on Books to Doors, the Red Eye Horror series, I think, or Red Eye Horror Books. They're all by different authors, and I might have to put it on my wish list because I just loved it. There is a sequel to this one. I have found it on Scribd, so what I might do is try and find it on there and see if I can read it. But yeah, they have lots of like different ones. So yeah, I might see if I can find some of those. Check them out on Scribd. If I think they're any good, then maybe I'll look at purchasing the set. If it was like a one-off fluke, then I've got it and it's fab. So yeah, they are all the books that I read in May. I actually did pretty well for me, because a lot of those were physical reads, whereas I tend to just consume a lot of my reading. I tend to consume a lot of my reading via audiobook, so I have the books on my shelves and then I think, oh, can I find it on Scribd or Libby? If I can, then I'll tend to listen to it on that because I know that I can do that while I'm pootling around and doing other bits and bobs. So yeah, that's a lot handier for me. But this month I had a lot of physical reads. I think there were two I listened to. I listened to Lyra Bird by Celia Ahern and Five Go After Camp by Enid Blyton. They were the only two that I could find by audiobook. I did read some of Last Orders at the Star and Sixpence on ebook, because that was on Scribd and I was out and about waiting for something. I think I had my card on and I hadn't bought a book or anything with me, which was silly really. But I managed to download it onto my phone to read while I was out and about, and that didn't cost me anything, so that was really nice to do. But yeah, I had a really, really decent reading month. I gave Frozen Charlotte 5 stars because I loved it. It was amazing. So yeah, fingers crossed I'll get to Knife in June. You'll find out, I suppose, at the end of June, beginning of July. Yeah, fingers crossed I can make a dent in those. I really hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you have read any of the books I have mentioned, let me know your thoughts, feelings. And yeah, and if you have any book recommendations, I am all ears. But yeah, that's it from me. Take care and I'll see you guys in the next video.